Signs are everywhere, from Washington to Beijing, from Moscow to the Persian Gulf, from Israel to the end of the earth. The nations are taking their positions in prophecy. The end-time battle lines have been drawn. Jesus is coming for his church. Are you prepared to understand how ancient prophecies are dominating today's international headlines? Join the Rapture with Faith Noble Adra, a gifted prophecy teacher, this and every Friday from 5 to 5:30 a.m. on Sky Power 93.5 FM. Now, here's today's message.
Call something the timing of the rapture. I'm not talking about the day that Jesus will come or the hour he will come. There are a lot of people in Christendom who believe very well that Jesus Christ will rapture the church, but there are three major opinions as to when it will take place, whether it will take place before the tribulation begins or it will take place in the middle of the tribulation. Better still, others believe it will take place at the end of the tribulation. But these are all opinions of people, and then definitely there is an element of truth in the whole stuff. So we'll be looking at what the Bible really said about it. Did the Bible teach that the church will go before, the church will go halfway through the tribulation, or even at the end of the tribulation? These theories are called the pre-tribulation rapture theory, and then what, mid-tribulation rapture theory, and post-tribulation. The mid says it will happen in the middle, the post says it will happen after the tribulation, meaning all of you have to suffer the terrific things that will happen in the tribulation. But the pre-tribulation rapture theory says it will happen before the tribulation begins. So I'll be taking you through scripture to see what, you know, when you study the three of them, it's a simple thing. Jesus Christ tags the church from the days of the apostles to be watching every day. If you look at the three of them, which of them generates the urgency and the need or validates Jesus Christ wanting to watch? Obviously, it has to do with the one, the Father. It will happen before all these things begin. Because if it will not happen before these things begin, then Jesus Christ's instruction to warn is invalid. Because definitely, if it's going to happen in the middle of the tribulation, every smart scholar would have to think this way. Well, then there's no need watching. We can talk about death, but not about the end time as Jesus asked us to do. Why? Because if it's going to happen in the middle of the tribulation, at least, as far as I know, I should see the Jewish temple rebuilt. Because we know it must be rebuilt in the tribulation period, or even before the tribulation begins. We must see the arise of the Antichrist. We must see the mark of the beast enforced before we tell people that, yeah, it's now the end time. And the worst of the opinion or the theory is the post one that says it will happen after the rapture of the church. And that is, there is a shallow argument to support that. It doesn't hold any water. If that is the case, then there's no need warning people about the end time. If everybody's going to go through the tribulation, then let's just wait. Then whatever Jesus said that we should watch, there is no need. When the tribulation comes and begins, the Antichrist starts issuing the mark, then we find how to escape, we find how to hide or do something like that. But the fact of the matter is that Jesus really thought that the church would be out of here before the hour of wrath come upon the earth. And I want to give you scriptural proofs to that effect. Hallelujah. I want you to take your pen and paper, put some of these things down and study for yourself. The first evidence that I want to show you that Jesus will keep the church out of the hour of wrath that is coming upon the earth is in 1 Thessalonians 1:8-10. 1 Thessalonians 1:8-10. The Bible says that was the apostle speaking to the church in Thessalonica. And this is what he wrote. He said, "The Lord's message rang out from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia. Your faith in God has become known everywhere. Therefore, we do not need to say anything about it. For they themselves report what kind of reception you gave us. They tell how you turned to God from your idols to serve the living and the true God And verse 10 says, and to wait for his son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescues us from the coming wrath. You get it? The Bible says Jesus Christ. That's what? This was an assurance to the church. Jesus Christ. We are waiting for his son from heaven, Jesus Christ, who rescues us from the coming wrath. So there is an assurance that the coming wrath, which is coming upon the whole earth like never before, like none that has ever happened in history before, Bible says Jesus Christ rescue us from the coming wrath. Again, I want to show you another one, another promise to keep the faithfuls of the body of Christ. Not every church goer anyway, not every bishop, not every pastor, not every apostle, not every church member, the faithfuls of Jesus Christ, those who love Jesus, did his will. Are you getting what I'm saying? Yeah, the day is going to make that clear. There's no two ways about that. Now let me take you to Revelation chapter 3 verse 7. In addressing one of the churches of Asia Minor, the church at Philadelphia, Jesus assured them of protection from the great trial that is coming upon the whole earth. This is how he put it, Revelation 3:7. He said, and to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, this thing said, he that is holy, he that is true, he that had the key of David, he that openeth and no man shut it. Then verse 10, let's jump to verse 10. It says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world, not part of the world, not upon Europe, not upon Africa, not upon Asia, but that shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Speaking about the great tribulation that is coming upon the earth, Jesus assured these guys, this church, Philadelphia, vibrant church, told them that because you have been faithful, because you have kept the word of my patience. They were not ridiculing Jesus that why is he taking so long time to come? Why are we suffering? Why are we going through mad thing? Why is Jesus not coming? They were not asking those bogus stuffs. They were not putting up those opinions. Bible said they have kept the word of his patience. And Jesus promised to keep such a church with such a character, out of the hour of wrath that is coming upon the whole world. So that is breathtaking to know that Jesus will keep us out of the hour of wrath. But the condition is keeping the word of his patience. Are you keeping the word of his patience? It's a very simple matter. Hallelujah. Now let me show you something again from the writings of the prophet Zephaniah chapter 2 verse 2 to 3. The prophet also spoke about escape. If you want to understand many of the things spoken about the period of the tribulation, the prophets of old, the prophets, all the major and the minor prophets, almost all of them spoke about the day of the Lord, talking about the same thing that is coming to happen. How interesting is such a day, such a period of 7 years, that all the prophets warn about it, the day of the Lord is at hand. The day of the Lord is so dreadful, a kind of period not designed for you, unless you decide to join the rebellious world that God will punish, show them a living hell on it. Hallelujah. So let me read to you what the prophet Zephaniah had to say about God's protection for those who change their minds, who repent of their sins. Zephaniah 2:2-3. Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you, seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth. Or seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment. Seek what? Righteousness. Seek meekness. It may be, ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. The prophet was calling on the people to seek righteousness, to seek meekness, to change, actually to repent. If they do that, the probability is that they will be hid from the hour of wrath that is coming upon the earth. Hallelujah. So you are getting it. I want you to understand that Jesus Christ will be keeping the church out of the hour of wrath that is coming upon the earth. And that is the purpose of the rapture. Are you getting it? Now let me show you. I want to give you all the scriptural proofs that we can do on this program for today. Even Jesus asked the church to pray for their protection, for their exemption out of the hour of wrath that is to come upon the earth. Again, you can put this scripture down. Luke 21:34-36. Luke, St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 21:34-36. Be careful, and it is conditional. Are you getting it? Be careful, or your hearts be weighed down with dissipation, that is to say, overindulgence, drunkenness, and the anxieties of life. Of course, a lot of people are caught up here. That's true. And that day will close on you unexpectedly, like a trap. For it will come upon all those who live on the face of the earth, not on Europeans, not on the Arabs, not on the Africans, but upon what? All those who live on the face of the whole earth. Verse 36 says, be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape. This is from Jesus' own mouth. He said, be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape. To escape all that is about to happen. Not some of the things that are about to happen. If Jesus has said some of them, it means, okay, maybe we have to go through the tribulation. Middle way, then we are caught up. Are you getting it? To be with the Lord. But Jesus said to escape all of the tribulation that is about to happen. Are you getting what I'm saying? And that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. Are you getting it? That is very important. So you can take this scripture again down. The prophet Isaiah also spoke about the same thing. Isaiah 26, 19, 21. About protection for God's people. Isaiah 26, 19 to 21. This is what the prophet said. But your dead will live. Talking about the resurrection again. But your dead will live. Their bodies will rise. You who dwell in the dust, wake up and shout for joy. I believe the prophet was talking about the rapture. Because the only resurrection that people benefit from and shout for joy is the rapture. Are you getting it? So he said what? You who dwell in the dust, wake up and shout for joy. Your dew is like the dew of the morning. The earth will give birth to her dead. Then verse 20, he says, go, my people, enter your rooms and shut the doors behind you. Hide yourselves for a little while until the wrath has passed by. See, the Lord is coming out of his dwelling to punish the people of the earth for their sins. Are you one of the people the Lord will be coming to punish? Advise yourself. The earth will disclose the blood shed upon her. And she will what? She will conceal her slain no longer. That is the word of the prophet Isaiah. So, before the Lord punished the people of the earth for their sins, he said, the dead will be raised. They are to shout for joy. And they are to enter their rooms. What rooms is he talking about? I spoke to you at length on that. I want to prove to you scripturally, because there are a lot of opinions surrounding things. A lot of us don't study the scripture, so we are just naive about many things, and anything goes for us. Now let me take you to show you another evidence that Jesus Christ will not include the church in the tribulation. He will take the church out of the earth before begin pouring the seals of the apocalypse on the face of the earth. You know, the 7-year period, it is not the Antichrist who is judging the earth. The Antichrist is just an executioner of God's judgment on earth. Are you getting it? Yeah. It's God who is judging. That is why it's called what? The day of the Lord. God is punishing the inhabitants. He wants them to taste a living hell on earth for rejecting all that he did for them. For rejecting his son. God wants to show the inhabitants of the earth that if I give you this great salvation and you still don't have time for it, you have time for your business than your salvation, then let me show you how it means. Those who will be saved must be saved through the hard way. And I explained to you the identity of those who will be saved. And to show the church that the believers who were playing hide and seek with him all this while that, yeah, it's good that I sent my son to die for your sins, but that is not going to last forever. At least, there has to come a time that you have to really bear the consequences on earth here before you proceed to hell. Are you getting what I'm saying? So the judgments that will be pouring out in the tribulation, they were actually released or authorized by Jesus Christ himself. How do we know that? You go to the book of Revelation again, chapter 6. The judgments in the tribulation, Jesus was the one who opened the seals. The 7 seals were opened by the Lamb. And John spoke about that. Let me read from verse 1 to 2 just to give you an idea about that. He said, now I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals. Who opened the seals of judgment? The seals that were opened were what? That's to authorize the reign of the Antichrist on earth. The second horse of the apocalypse was about what? Was it war on earth. The third one about famine, pestilence, diseases,
Many great earthquakes, things happen in the tribulation. Who opened their sails for that? It is the very Lamb, the one who is the bridegroom of the church. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. So how will Jesus pour his wrath upon his own bride on earth? No way. It is unthinkable. It is not possible. It is not true. So the wrath of God that will be authorized by Jesus Christ in those days is for the rebellious people of the earth, the disobedient people of the earth. Let me show you the scripture proof to that. Let me take you to Colossians chapter 3 verse 6. I believe today we are studying, so just put the scriptures down. Hallelujah. Yeah, many of you don't study the word of God. You have to put some of these things down. These things will concern all of you. It's just a matter of time. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 3 verse 6. Bible says, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience. So you see whom the kind of people that great tribulation is designed for. What? The children of what? Disobedience. Romans 5:9 says, much more than being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. So the wrath that is coming, the wrath of God, the wrath of the Lamb that is coming, Bible says, those of us who have been justified by what? His blood. Not by what we think about ourselves, not by money, which we are giving much more prominence in the church and in our life today. Those who have been justified by what? His blood. You cannot be justified by money because you run from it and hide in caves and in bush to escape the persecution by the global police system that is coming. Are you aware of that? Yeah. Today we give all these things prominence in our life. Christianity is all about money today. Church is all about money today. Every message preached on the pulpit is designed to conscientize people to produce more money. You cannot be justified by any of that. The days are coming when you cannot even access your money in the bank unless you receive the new technology implanted under your skin. Are you aware of that? You go to the bank, they tell you your account is not accessible. What are you going to do? They ask you, have you registered on the new technology introduced by the new world government? They explain that it is for your own security. By then you realize that, yeah, this is the mark of the beast that the preachers of old have been warning about. It will dawn on you. Then you may want to run away. The global police system will pick you up and send you to concentration camps. These are the hard days that are coming ahead of the world. Nothing can save you. Nothing can justify you and provide you an escape. Save the blood of Jesus Christ. That is the very thing the poppies are not talking about. You see, some of you are not smart. I know some of you are very eager. You can protect your business. You won't allow anybody to mess up with your business. But you can sit under a preacher who preach to you rubbish, business, and a lot of things. You wake up and go back to the house. You are wasting your time. You are wasting your time. Some of you have to shine your eyes. Yeah, the preacher, he's not a watchman over my business. He's a watchman over my soul. That is the first thing. If my soul is not secure, the preacher has no business telling me about fables and stories. Yeah, I'm talking about my soul here. Many of you will not understand. By the time will come, said what? Much more than being justified by his blood. Every preacher, every church member should be asking himself, am I justified by his blood? Am I justified? You see, a lot of things are happening. It is only the blood that is going. You see. You don't know. There are a lot of things in the pipeline. The very days we are speaking about are not far away. Every now and then you are going to be hearing about those things like financial downturn. These things are orchestrated by men, few at least, who want a world government. When these financial stuff collapses, they plan how to mess up with the global economy so that they can institute more regulations to control the sovereignty of nations, take their sovereignty from them, say, no, we have to rescue the global economy from whatever, whatever. You see all these things. We have to monitor everybody's transaction for the interest of the international community. We need to track terrorists. We need to do all these things. They are infringing on your rights and doing all these things. But many of you don't know. Many of you are on social networks. Do you know, I've been speaking to you about global monitoring systems. Some of you, all your life is on social network. Hallelujah. Facebook, Twitter. You have no idea about what is about to happen in this world. How many of you know, even the violence that is happening in UK, how do they get some of the culprits through mails that they send? If you have privacy, why do they check your mail? Why do they check your Facebook, what you do? How do they access your password? You see, you don't know.
The world has advanced. I don't have time to tell you about all that. But I'm telling you that nothing is going to justify you save the blood of Jesus Christ from the wrath that is to come. Are you getting it? All the human rights organizations who promote abortions, killing 100 million babies every year globally, who promote the cause of gays, cannot save you because they will be condemned, consumed, and destroyed by the glory of the King of Kings who is coming. His countenance alone will consume all of them. Nothing is going to save you. Only the blood of Jesus. Today, are you justified by that blood? Are you getting it? Bible says, for which things sake the wrath of God come upon what? The children of disobedience. Who are the children of disobedience? Not the bride of Christ. All the abortionists, pedophiles, gays, thieves, blasphemers, disobedient children, the sexually corrupt, pornography stars. Some of you are virtual candidates. Bible says, you are the very reason for which the wrath of God is coming. The church of God is going to be kept out of the hour of wrath that is coming upon this earth. Are you getting it? Are you getting it? For which things is the wrath of God come upon children? Your pastor cannot justify you. He'll be hot himself. If he's left down, he'll be very hot himself. If he's going to care about anybody, he's going to care about his family. And if I were him, that's the very thing I would do. Yeah! You don't know what it meant to have Jesus Christ all to yourself today. You don't know it. Politicians cannot justify you because their governments will be taken away from them. They will be the first people to go for the mark of the beast and come and implement it in their countries. Are you aware of that? Hallelujah. I'm telling you, Bible says, for which things sake the wrath of God come upon the children of disobedience. And Bible says we are saved. We are justified through his blood. Those of us who are justified through his blood, we shall also be saved from the coming wrath. You cannot be justified by the United Nations. Because he shall be tried by the fiery tribunal of the King of Kings. And they will be found guilty of double standards. They will be found guilty of funding many of the wars in the world today. Their propaganda, everything. I'm telling you, the blood of the Lamb is the only thing that can save you. Are you getting me? I faith, I cannot save you. I cannot go to hell in your place. That must be clear to you. I cannot save you. So why would God send his son to die for you? So that you'll be saved from the wrath to come. Jesus didn't go to the cross merely to save people from only poverty, just to give people more money to produce a Laodicean church. Jesus was sent to the cross to save you from the eternal wrath of God. And those of you who are not making use of this great salvation, it is time we tell you the truth plain in the face, so that you advise yourself. Jesus Christ will save us. Okay, now let me show you again. The Bible tells us that another evidence that Jesus will keep the church out of the hour of wrath is that he gave us the instances in the days of Lot to learn from. Bible says the same day Lot left out of Sodom, God rained fire upon them. So the same day that we will be living, God will do the same thing. We have to depart before. Abraham asked God, will you destroy the righteous with the wicked? God said, no, it is not in my disposition to do that. That same day Noah entered the ark, the judgment came upon them. The same day we are gone. Everything, all the madness will come out of their faces. Hallelujah. Are you getting it? So now the question is this. Where are we going to? Some of those who argue that the rapture takes place in the tribulation or even after the tribulation, some of them argue that, it is true that Jesus will protect the church, but Jesus will protect the church on earth, not in heaven. Are you getting what I'm saying? He'll keep the church here, but provide them special security. But let me show you something. And they cite those instances like when the Israelites were to mark the doorposts of their buildings with the blood, and that God kept them right down here and punished the Egyptians. But this is the point. If you study the tribulation, every smart scholar who knows about this area very well, you know that before the tribulation begins in Revelation 7, we are notified that some people were sealed on their foreheads so that they will not be hurt by the wrath of the Lamb. And we were given their identities. They were what? 144,000 people. Well, those people are having special forces. They will be doing special works, operations. The works that many of us cannot do now, evangelism. Those guys will be doing those works in the tribulation. They were the only people sealed. Aside them, every other person is supposed to be punished by all the wrath that is coming in the tribulation. Whether they were believers left behind or they were now new converts in the tribulation, all of them will be tormented and punished adequately. Are you getting what I'm saying? Take this thing very serious. Should the rapture happen today, it will be a blow to many, many of you. Let me show you something here. For instance, let me take you to one of the plagues that will happen in the tribulation, where it is stated that everybody will be punished by this plague
except those sealed on their foreheads. So the question is, if the church will be given a hiding place in the tribulation on earth, why is it that we don't hear about the church being sealed on their foreheads? Just 144,000 people. The reason is that the church is going to heaven.
Let me take you to Revelation 9:1-6.
One of the places that is supposed to punish everybody on the earth. Bible says, then the fifth angel sounded, and I saw a staff falling from heaven to the earth.
To him was given the key to the bottomless pit, and he opened the bottomless pit, and smoke arose out of the pit like the smoke of a great furnace. So the sun and the air were darkened because of the smoke of the pit. Then out of the smoke locusts came upon the earth, and to them was given power as the scorpions of the earth have power. They were commanded not to harm the grass of the earth or any green thing or any tree, but only those men who do not have the seal of God on their foreheads.
So those who have the seal of God on their foreheads, they are the only people to be exempted. If the church is here, it means God is commanding that all of them should be punished, which is not true.
The answer is that the church is gone out of the world at the rapture. You see why we have to be warning the church about Jesus coming. Hallelujah.
Yeah, all these punishments are coming upon the earth. There's no two ways about it. It will punish everybody, every politician, every rebellious Christian. It will punish all of them. It will combine all of them. Nobody will be spared. Bible says they will be stung for 5 months and they will not die.
Are you getting what I'm saying? Yeah, men have always argued that they are competent enough to run the world all by themselves without God or His Spirit or His Word. And now God shows them that He's sovereign over the affairs of men. How many of you today, you want to talk to somebody, you tell them this thing you are doing, it's not, God doesn't tolerate it, it's not in consonance with the Bible, they tell you leave the Bible out of this. Oh, we are competent, we are in the 21st century.
Men always tell God they don't need His word because they're in the 21st century, where what is right or wrong is a matter of personal preference.
At this time He will prove to them that the earth and the fullness thereof is for Him and Him alone, not the architects of the new world order, not for the Illuminati, not for the Freemasons, not for the Bilderberger group, not for the Knights of the Malta, not for the United Nations, not for the gay rights activists, their learned professors and doctors, not for the Antichrist, but for Him whose name is I Am That I Am.
He shall judge and purge this earth of all these atrocities, and that is the opinion of God. But the Bible says, my Spirit shall not always strive with man. One day, God is going to take His Spirit out of this world. Hallelujah. Now let me show you another reason. So where is the church? The church is not on earth. Jesus said, in my Father's house, there are many mansions. That is exactly where He's taking the church to, before the tribulation begins. Are you getting it? Now let me show you this very important point of why Jesus will take the church out of the world.
The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20 that so we are ambassadors of Christ. God is making His appeal through us. We beseech you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God.
We are what? Ambassadors of Christ.
We are ambassadors of Christ.
And it is only logical and appropriate that as ambassadors, if our government is about to declare war on this ungodly planet, we are taken out of the world. Simple.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
The Bible says our citizenship is in heaven. We are not citizens of this earth. We are ambassadors doing the bidding of heaven on earth here. We are campaigning for our government on earth here. We are emissaries. We are high commissioners on earth here. Every believer, every preacher,
a true preacher, every true believer.
We are heaven's diplomats. The Bible says we are aliens, strangers on earth. Now, heaven is about to declare war on this earth. What happens when NATO was about to begin its campaign? After the resolution in 1973 or something is passed, what did you see the NATO member countries doing? Britain withdrew her ambassadors from Libya. The Americans did the same. Why? Because they are coming to implement the resolution. As ambassadors of Jesus Christ, God is about to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their rebellion. What is going to happen? Jesus is going to withdraw His ambassadors. We are going to go. Heaven is going to cut all diplomatic ties with this earth,
this ungodly earth. Are you getting it?
Only essential staff will be left here. Hallelujah. And they are the 144,000 people. Can't you see that they have been given special skills? They are having special forces. They will be carrying out a lot of special operations in the tribulation. You and I have no mandate anymore.
Are you an ambassador of Christ?
Are you a pastor? Are you doing heaven's bidding? Or you have joined this rebellious world and you are preaching business, preaching materialism, doing all these things? If heaven is recalling ambassadors, will heaven be proud of you enough to recall you? It's a very simple question.
Will heaven recall you? Because heaven will soon be passing a resolution. authorizing the use of all force and firepower necessary to halt all this madness and rebellion against God on the face of the earth. But before that, we'll be taken out of this world. Would you also be part of it? Simple. Are you an ambassador of Christ? Are you an emissary of Christ on earth? Can heaven boast of you? Does heaven still recognize you? Or you are like an ambassador who has teamed up with the world? You have come to join. You are comfortable here. So it's not about the mandate of your home government again. Our home government is heaven. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Yeah, I want to talk to you on a little more thing. But friends, time is running out. Salvation today is so clear, so obvious. You can easily access it. You don't need to go and hide in caves, forests to serve God. Salvation today is so simple and the commonest news in town. You don't need money to purchase it. Only repent and believe the gospel. Don't miss it, because the time is coming when things will change. You cannot move freely in this world without being pursued day and night to receive a mark from hell. Days are coming to this world when a man who has not gone to be with the Lord cannot sleep for a minute in his fine house, nor can he drive his fine car in town freely. Very notable people, respected people, professors, doctors, who didn't cherish this great salvation will be sleeping in caves and forests to escape the worst global persecution to come. Are you saved? Are you washed by the blood of the Lamb? Today may be your last opportunity. God bless you for being on the rapture this day. I hope God has spoken to you. If you don't know Jesus Christ, if you are not justified by his blood, if you are just having fun in church, you don't know Jesus Christ. You know your life doesn't look like somebody who is justified by his blood. I want you to make this decision of faith. Pray this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I believe you died for my sins. I believe God raised you from the dead. This day I come to you in repentance. Change my life. Make me new again. And let me be a faithful servant of you, so that when you appear, I'll be like you. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Until the same time next week, remember, the church will be out of here, because the wrath of God is meant for the children of disobedience. God bless you. Amen.